spectrographic characterization of Al2O3 particulate reinforced Al2014 alloy composite subjected to tensile load. The overview of the presentation. Composite material having a two faces, matrix and reinforcement face. Some of the features of the composites are listed below. Motivation behind this research work is, before starting this work, a lot of interactions has been made with the design engineers from HAL Bangalore. During the interactions, we came to know that a lot of efforts are being made to reduce the weight of the aircraft components such as bulkheads, wing root fittings by using Al2014 alloy. Hence, to overcome this, Al2014 alloy reinforced with Al2O3 particulates. Based on the motivations, the following objectives are defined. Following are the methods available for producing the MMCs. Among this, in the present work, melt steering has been used to produce the composite. These are the novelties present in the research work. Flowcharts will give you the clear idea how two-stage stir casting has been used to produce the composites. Figure 1A will show the semi-images as cast, whereas B, C, D will show the semi-images of 9-15 weight percentage of Al2O3 particulates, which clearly give you an idea how uniformly Al2O3 particulates are dispersed. Figure 2 will show the EDS of Al2014 aluminum alloy and 9 weight percentage of Al2O3 particulate composites. Figure 3 will show the micro hardness values of the produced composite. With increasing the weight percentage, the micro hardness values of the produced composite increases. Figure 4A and 4B will show the increase in the UTS and yield strength values of the produced composite compared to the base alloy. Figure 5A, B, C, and D will show the strain curve for as cast and the produced composites. Figure 6 will show the decrease in the percentage elongation with increase in the weight percentage of Al2O3 particulates. Figure 7A will show the factorographic as cast, which shows the large and uniform size of the dip, whereas the produced composite showing tiny whites owing to the strain localization. These conclusions has been brought from the obtained results. And these are the references. Thank you.